Be me. Forever DM. Be not me. Human paladin. Half elf druid. Half orc barbarian. Dragonborn wizard. And human mystic. Be playing 2-year-long expansive 5e campaign. Despite all odds, not a single player character has died. Until now. Characters started campaign at odds with each other, escaping a prison and only staying together out of necessity. Human mystic is the biggest dick in the group, only one with evil alignment. Constantly detests the rest of the party for first few months. Party finally finds out why. Mystic's entire family is cult of evil mystics that used their psychic powers to warp his mind from the time he was a baby. Barbarian understands better than most. His father raped his mother, which resulted in him being born. Father trained him from a young age to kill anything that wasn't orc. Barbarian got sick of this. Killed his own father. Mystic doesn't know how to feel about this. Skip ahead a few in-game months. Party is fighting the first beg of the campaign. Beg causes massive crack to open in the ground right beneath Mystic. Mystic falls into the crack, over just 200 feet down. Barbarian jumps in after him, grabs him in midair, twists himself so his back hits the ground, and eats all 112 fall damage while the Mystic takes virtually none. Barbarian starts rolling death saves. For the first time in the campaign, the Mystic rolls a medicine check to stabilize a dying teammate. Mystic player declares, "I think my alignment just changed," as rest of the party manages to slay the first beg, saving the entire city from destruction. Paladin uses daggers to carry both Mystic and Barbarian out of crack in the ground, rolling insanely high on athletics to do so. Cleric heals Barbarian and Mystic back to decent health. Wizard cleans them up with prestidigitation, and Druid makes the group some ice cold glasses of victory water. Create water doesn't specify it can be cold, but fuck it, it doesn't say it can't be cold. From then on, Mystic becomes much more of a team player. Starts taking abilities to aid party in battles, becomes much less of a dick. Fast forward to in real life years. Party of adventurers now killed 2 more begs, including the most powerful lich the world had ever known and finally a Terisk. Both deserve their own stories, but not right now. After the previous battle, the Mystic player approached me in private to discuss something about his character. I had told the players that a festival was going to be starting soon, within the next 2 in-game months. The Mystic wanted to do something special for the party during the festival. When the next arc started, the Mystic character wasn't with the party. Claimed he had something important to do but would return in a few days. Few in-game days pass. Mystic keeps his word and returns to the party. This time the party isn't dealing with a tangible villain they can punch in the face. They are dealing with another plane of existence crashing into the material plane. If that happens, both planes of existence would be destroyed. The party had to quickly gather materials on missions across both planes to construct a bomb capable of atomizing an entire plane. After they get the materials and start constructing it, I have them roll skill checks to see how well they build the bomb, having DCs set for every task. They fail only one check. Possibly the most important check. They also fail to notice their mistake, and continue making the bomb. Go to the second, hell-like plane threatening the material plane through a portal. Only minutes left until both planes are destroyed. Bomb is set up in such a way that a light will turn green when it's armed, triggering a 10-second countdown. The light doesn't turn green, no matter how many times they press the remote detonator. They realize that the countdown mechanism isn't working. 1 minute to planes collide. Paladin knows what he has to do. Starts walking towards the bomb and telling everyone to get through the portal. Barbarian isn't having it. Nat 20s a punch to the back of the paladin's head to knock him out. Paladin fails con save to wake up. Mystic pleads with Barbarian not to do this. Barbarian assures Mystic everything will be okay. Asks Mystic not to fight him over this. Mystic eventually promises he won't fight him. As he walks away, Mystic whispers something to Druid. Barbarian looks at his party. Wizard is able to drag Paladin through portal, leaving only the Mystic and Druid. He waves goodbye at them. But then the Druid turns into a Titan Bear, a homebrew bear I made that is very strong. Mystic uses an ability that allows him to swap places with the Barbarian. And the moment he does, the druid wraps his huge arms around the barbarian and starts pulling him into the portal. Barbarian enters rage mode to try and break free of druid. Just barely fails his rolls due to bad luck. Mystic smiles before his two friends go through the portal. I give him enough time to say something before they leave. I'll buy you a beer when this is over. Now get out of here, you idiots. The portal closes as they leave through it, leaving the Mystic alone in a hellish landscape with the bomb. Barbarian player is genuinely crying at this point while I describe what happens. The Mystic pushes a button on the bomb that turns the light green, sits down with his back against the bomb, and smiles before being atomized along with the rest of the plane. Back in the material plane, the rest of the party lives with the aftermath. The bomb worked. The other plane was completely destroyed, saving the material plane from destruction. People across the globe sang praise of the party, worshipping them as true heroes of the realm. I skipped ahead by 1 month, explaining to the party that they all received individual letters addressed to them. They all passed an investigation to notice the handwriting on the letter was from the Mystic. Before the final mission, the Mystic had written individualized letters for each party member. The player who controlled the Mystic has actually written these letters and started reading them out loud to each player. I sit back and let him have the reins for this part. Each party member received exactly enough money in each envelope for a beer at the local tavern. The party would always start each arc in, as was the tradition. Each player at this point actually started to cry while the Mystic player read each real letter. The barbarian character, however, received enough money for 2 beers. In the letter, the Mystic stated, "Now you don't have an excuse to not buy me a beer the next time we go to the tavern." We actually had to hold the campaign here for a minute while the barbarian player bawled like a child. When I first started Ming all those years ago, I never expected to have a campaign go on for this long. I also never expected to have players that cared this genuinely and passionately about their characters, so much so that they would start to cry when one of them died. Sure, you could argue that D&D is just a game that people play to pass the time, but I no longer feel that way. D&D has given me and my friends memories I don't think I'll soon forget. It's something that brings us together and lets us experience another world with true friends we wouldn't otherwise be able to experience. I love Dungeons and Dragons.